make sure it worked. You know, how do we know what's happening back and forth? How do you communicate with this guy via telephone? We got a telephone connection from him to him. The irony is beautiful. We're using a telephone network to prove a technology that's going to eat the lunch of the telephone network. But actually, it was one of these really old phones, the kind that the old operators used to use. It comes around here with a little mouthpiece here. I have it in my office. Okay, we're ready to go. So Charlie typed the L, and he said, "You get the L?" And Bill said, "Yep, got the L." Charlie typed the O, "You get the O?" "Yep, got the O." Charlie typed the G, "You get the G?" Crash! So what was the first message of on the internet? Low.
Low.
Lo and behold. A few comments. First of all, the and behold came later.
Yeah, much shorter than what hath God wrought.
Exactly. But you know what hath God. How many of you knew what the message was before I just told you? How many of you who didn't know ever thought to ask the question, what was it? The kids out walking down the hall, they don't know. And they don't even wonder about it. But these guys, like Samuel Morse, the telegraph, or Alexander Graham Bell with the phone, or Neil Armstrong with the man on the moon, they were smart. They had messages ready. What hath God wrought? That was a pretty good one, right? Or come here, Watson, I need you, or Giant Leap for Mankind. They understood public relations, media, and all the rest. We didn't have a camera. Yeah. We didn't have a sound recording. There's only one written record I'll show you later of this